everyone, welcome to Priyanka's collaborative learning. In today's lesson, we are going to study marginal costing. What we will learn today? We'll learn the multiple choice question, that too practical ones. Under the costing, the subject or the topic is marginal costing. And I will teach you today the easiest way to solve all the numericals, concept plus and make you do question practice also. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe to the Telegram channel. Link is given in the description box. Why I am telling you to subscribe to Telegram channel? Because I solve doubts there. I share my notes. All the notifications of my videos you will get there, and you will get by subscribing to YouTube channel also. So I hope you get benefited from this lecture. Stay tuned till last to learn marginal costing very conceptually and in detail. Let's get started with the video. So, profit volume ratio, it is a relationship between profit, contribution and sales, okay? So it is termed as contribution to sales ratio. PVR is considered to be the best indicator of profitability in business. The higher the PVR, the better it is for business. The firm is enjoying steady business conditions over a period of time. For so many years, the PVR will also remain stable and steady, okay? So let's understand this. So the first thing that they have told is profit volume ratio is the relationship between profit, contribution and sales. There are three terms. First is profit, second is contribution and the third one is sales. It is also termed as contribution to sales ratio. PVR is considered to be the best indicator of profitability in business. So my dear students, don't panic. This is just a simple chart which we have to learn. For example, if there is a firm of chairs, they manufacture what? Chairs. And for chairs, what is the raw material needed? Chairs, wood is needed, and another thing which is needed is polishing material and the machines or the carving, if they are done manually, if they are doing all the labor is doing manually, the labor cost. So for example, the manufacturing cost of a chair is rupees 50. So this is the variable cost, okay? This is a variable cost, and they sell the chair at rupees 80. So the difference between this 30 rupees, is it profit? Completely profit. Can the shopkeeper take it at home? No, he cannot. He has to concentrate on fixed cost also, because some organizations are on rent. For example, his factory is on rent of 3000 rupees. He has a small factory which is of 3000 rupees and it is in a village or so. Okay, his rent is very nominal, let's guess. Okay, so first he has to recover the fixed cost, which is compulsory to pay. Either he'll do production or he'll not do production. He has to pay the rent of the factory anyhow. Okay, so 3000 he has to pay. From this amount of contribution, he will pay first the fixed cost. Okay, fixed cost is not just a rent. It has electricity bills which will come fixed. Okay, if the electricity connection he has taken, or the house, or the help he has taken for the sanitation and other facilities, those expenses are also fixed. So all the fixed category expenses comes under the fixed cost. So he has to use that 30 rupees per unit amount of contribution, the amount he is getting from contribution, for the payment of fixed cost. And after he'll pay fixed cost, the amount which will be left is called profit. Okay, so this contribution is not profit. Okay, so let's understand this. So what is PVR? PVR is nothing but contribution upon sales into 100. So how we'll calculate the contribution, I'll explain you later on in the next slides. Now comes the next slide. Margin of safety is the difference between actual sales and the break-even sales. My dear students, we all have learned in economics. What we have learned? That break-even point is a point where firm incurs neither profits nor losses. Firm is not incurring anything. What the firm has put into a business, firm has got its output in the same manner. They have done work, they have done everything, but they are not incurring any losses. They are not gaining any profits also. So the firm is not having any profits, no loss. No profit, no loss situation, that means the firm has nothing. The firm which was there is still there. They have not proceeded even, and they have not degraded even. So that is a break-even point. So at break-even point, the profits are zero. The loss is also zero. No profit, no loss. Okay. So if I talk about, if the firm is at break-even point, is it earning profit? No. But firm, when goes above the break-even point, it is called as margin of safety. For example, at 20,000 units, firm is not having any profits, no loss. Okay, this is a break-even point for the firm. No profit, no loss. Now, if the firm is going till 25,000 units, it is incurring little bit of profits. Now it goes to 35,000, it will earn more and more and more profits. So this level, which is beyond the break-even level, this is margin of safety level. Okay, and these two sales level are combinedly known as total sales. So what is the total sales? Total sales is equals to margin of safety plus break-even sales. Understanding my point? So total sales is equals to margin of safety plus break-even sales. So this is very simple concept. So if the MOS is higher, it represents the strength of the organization, that the organization is very wealthy. It has a good goodwill. It is a reputed organization. A high MOS gives confidence to the organization, and a low MOS may wipe off the profits. It may even below, if it is going below the break-even point, it can incur losses also. So there are few more formulas. MOS in units, if you have to calculate, then you have to divide the profit by contribution per unit. And if you have to calculate MOS in value, that means you have to divide the profit by PBR. Okay, moving towards. So this is the easiest way to solve practicals. Sales minus variable cost gives contribution minus fixed cost gives profit. So this is a very simple thing. If I am deducting variable cost from sales, what I'll get? I'll get contribution, and that contribution is not profit. It will be used in paying the fixed cost. And after the fixed cost is being paid, the amount which is left over will be the profit. So this you have to remember for all the questions. This is a must statement for all the questions. Please write it down if you are seeing my video. Now comes the next chart, which is a basic learning formula chart, how to learn the formulae. Just write a basic formula: total sales is equals to margin of safety sales plus break-even sales. If you will write this formula, then what you have to do? You have to do nothing. Just write multiply, 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 PVR, PVR, PVR. Okay, then you know that if you will multiply PVR in sales, you will get contribution. If you will multiply PVR in margin of safety, you will get profit. And if you will multiply break-even sales into PVR, you will get fixed cost. And now another formula which has been derived on its own is contribution is equals to profit plus fixed cost. Okay. Now another first in this category of PVR, how you will calculate the PVR? You will calculate by contribution upon sales into 100. But in this category, this is used, change in profit upon change in sales is also PVR. This is used when 2 years data is given. 2 years profit is given, 2 years sales is given. You have to find out the difference between two and you have to divide them, and then the new PVR will come. Okay, I will teach you how. So this is a basic formula chart for the remembrance of formulas. Now comes, these are the questions which we are going to solve today, and these are very good questions, and I have started from a root level to a high level, so I hope you get benefited. Now comes question number 68. See, the numeric sequence is wrong, but I have put the questions from a good book, that is NSR Taxman, which is a good book, and these questions can come in exam. And they can ask you anything related to this question. They will change figures also. I have seen in exams these type of questions. So I hope you learn it properly. Take a pen and paper and solve with me. Okay. So this is the first question of the day. Selling price per unit is rupees 10. Variable cost is 8 per unit. Fixed cost is 20,000. And break-even production in units you have to find out. So is it 10,000, 16,000, 300, 2,000 or 2,500? Okay. So we know that the basic formula we know, which is selling sales minus variable cost gives contribution minus fixed cost. If you will do, you will get profit. So this is a basic formula, right? Now moving towards, if I have sales rupees 10, my variable cost is rupees 8. How much contribution I am getting? Rupees 2. My fixed cost is 20,000. And at break-even production, profits are zero, as it is no profit, no loss situation. We know that. Okay, now I have to calculate BEP units. So as you know by the chart which I taught you, total sales is equals to margin of safety plus break-even sales. Okay, if I am multiplying PVR PVR and PVR into it, what I am getting? I am getting how much? Here I am getting fixed cost, here I am getting profit, here I am getting contribution. Okay, so now if I have to calculate break-even sales, what I'll do? I'll divide the fixed cost by PVR. I will go opposite, in an opposite manner. If you look at the formula, break-even sales into PVR is equals to fixed cost. Okay. Now, if I have to find out the, if I have been given fixed cost, I have been given PVR. Now, how I'll calculate break-even sales? I'll do simply break-even sales is equals to fixed cost upon PVR. Now, we have to calculate PVR also. So, our contribution is 2 and the sales is 10. So, contribution upon sales into 100, that is 2 upon 10 into 100, that is 20% is my PVR. Okay. So, nothing we have to do now. We have been given fixed cost. We have to calculate break-even sales. Fixed cost is 20,000. And I have to apply the PVR there, that is 20 upon 100, that is 20%. If I'll further do it, 20,000 into 100 upon 20. So my answer is 1 lakh is my break-even sales in value. But I have to calculate in units. So I'll divide it by sales unit. How much was my sales unit? Rupees 10. So my answer is 10,000 units. Okay. Moving towards the next question. Sales is 25,000, variable cost is 8,000, fixed cost is 5,000, and you have to calculate break-even sales in value. Okay, so now comes, this is a very easy question also, but numerically, it is a bit difficult to calculate. But it is not for you because you know the approach, how to solve it. So whenever these type of questions come, we have seen the word break-even sales, that means the profit are zero. We are assuming what? Profits are zero only. At break-even point, profits are zero. There is no loss also. So, if I'll write sales minus variable cost gives contribution minus fixed cost gives profit. Okay. So, I am assuming profit at zero. Fixed cost they have given? Yes. They have given 5,000. Contribution they have given? No. Variable cost they have given? 8,000. And talking about 25,000 is their sales. So, if you deduct 8,000 out of 25,000, you will get the contribution as 17,000. Okay. Now, if I have to calculate the PVR, we know from the formula that total sales is equals to MOS plus break-even sales. And if I'll multiply PVR in break-even sales, what I'll get? I'll get fixed cost. So, I have been given fixed cost. If I'll calculate PVR, I'll get break-even sales. Okay. So, I am calculating the PVR first. Okay. 17,000 divided by how much? Sales value. 25,000 into 100. Okay. Likewise, I'll do. What I'll get? How I calculated? Contribution upon sales into 100. That is 17,000 divided by 25,000 into 100. It will come 68%. Now, I have to do nothing. All is solved. I have to calculate break-even sales, so I have to find out the fixed cost. Fixed cost is given. PVR I have already calculated, 68%. Okay, so 5,000 divided by 68%, if you will do, you will get 7352.9. And my dear students, they have asked break-even sales in value, not in units. So, in value, the answer is 7352.9. So, can I take 7353? Yes, I can. So, the answer is option number B, 7353. Moving towards the next question. Fixed cost is rupees 80,000. Variable cost, rupees 2 per unit. Selling price, 10 per unit. Turnover required for profit target of 60,000. Okay. So, we have to calculate sales value. Turnover means what? Sales. Okay, we have to calculate this sales value for a profit of 60,000. Now, if you make that chart, sales minus variable cost give contribution minus fixed cost give profit. So you have to maintain a profit level of 60,000 and you have to calculate at how much sales the profit will be 60,000. Have you been given fixed cost? Yes, you have been given. So 80,000 is your fixed cost. If I'll add up these both, will I get contribution? Yes, I'll get. So 1,40,000 is my contribution. Okay. Now you know that the selling price is 10 rupees per unit. Here it is given. And you also know that the variable cost is rupees 2 per unit. So your answer is 8 rupees per unit is your contribution. If you will divide this 1,40,000 divided by 8, will you get contribution in units? Yes, you will get. Okay, so if I am doing 1,40,000 divided by 8, what you will get? 17,500 units. Now simply, if you will multiply 17,500 into 10, what you will get? 1,75,000 your sales value. If the question asks variable cost, what you will do? 17,500 into 2, what you will get? You will get 35,000. And if you will deduct these both, 1,40,000. Hence the answer is rectified also. Okay. So the answer to our question is the turnover required is 1,75,000. I hope you got it. Now moving towards the next question of the day. Sales is equals to 25,000, variable cost 15,000, fixed cost 4,000, PV ratio you have to calculate. So it is very simple. Sales minus variable cost is equals to contribution minus fixed cost is equals to profit. This is our basic formula. So sales is 25,000, variable cost is 15,000. So what is the contribution? 10,000, right? 10,000 is your contribution. Now you have to calculate PVR. So PVR is nothing, 10,000 contribution upon sales, 25,000 into 100. So how I am going to do this? It is 40%, simple. So the answer is A, 40%. Now moving towards the next question, question number 72. Okay, sales you have been given 50,000, variable cost is 30,000, net profit is 6,000, fixed cost is how much? Okay, they have been asking fixed cost is how much? So you have to calculate the fixed cost. It is also a simple question. Now comes how to solve it. Sales minus variable cost gives contribution minus fixed cost gives profit. So is profit given? Yes, it is given. It is given 6,000. Is fixed cost given? No, we have to find it out. So I am writing X here. So is the sales given? Yes, 50,000 is the sales. Is the contribution given? No. Is the variable cost given? Yes. So can I calculate the contribution? 20,000 is the contribution. So what I will deduct from 20,000, this value, to get so that I may get 6,000. So what will I deduct? So my fixed cost is nothing but 14,000. If 14,000 is deducted from 20,000, then only 6,000 profit will come. Now it is a common sense. You just have to put everything up in a table. Now, then you will get it. I hope you got the answer. The answer is B, 14,000. Now comes the next question of the day, question number 73. Actual sales 4 lakh, break-even sales 2,50,000, margin of safety in percentage you have to find out, percentage. So here comes the bit new question series. Okay, so total sales is equals to margin of safety plus break-even sales. Understanding my point? So actual sales they have given 4 lakhs. Margin of safety, we don't know. We have to calculate its percentage. So I'm writing MOS here because I don't know. Break-even sales, they have given 2,50,000. So if I'll deduct 2,50,000 from 4 lakh, what will I get? I'll get 1,50,000 as MOS. Okay, this will be my basic figure. So how much is this 1,50,000 of 4 lakh? Because I have to calculate in percentage. So what will I do? MOS in percentage is equals to 1,50,000 divided by 4 lakh into 100. So if I am going to do this, 1,50,000 divided by 100 divided by 4 lakh into 100. 1,50,000 divided by 4 lakh into 100. So I'm getting 37.5%. So my answer is option number C, 37.5%. I hope you got it. Moving towards the next question. G makes one product which it sells for 80 rupees per unit. Fixed cost are 28,000 per month. Marginal cost are rupees 42 a unit. What sales level in units will provide a profit of 10,000? You have to calculate the sales level in units which will give you a profit of 10,000. So here I have been given the sales value, that is 80 rupees per unit. Now we know the basic chart. Okay. So here profit, they have given in the question, I have to acquire sales on the profit of 10,000. Fixed cost they have given 28,000 per month. Okay. Now they have given marginal cost and variable cost are one and the same thing. Don't get confused. So marginal cost are 42. Okay. Now comes 38 per unit as the, this is the per unit going on and this is the main thing going on, the value ones. Okay. So 38 rupees is my per unit contribution. Now, if you will see that I am deducting fixed cost from contribution, then I am getting profit. And if I'll do the reverse, that means I'll add up profit and fixed cost. What will I get? I'll get contribution. Okay. If I'll add up profit and fixed cost, I'll get contribution. So that's what I am doing. 38,000 is my contribution value. So if you will divide these both, you will get the units. 1000 units is your sales value for acquiring a profit of 10,000. We'll do it again for rectifying it. Okay. So what they are telling in the question, it's very simple, my dear students. See, sales minus variable cost gives contribution minus fixed cost gives profit. We want a profit of 10,000. Fixed cost is given 28,000. If you will add up both, you will get contribution 38,000. On the other hand, if you will go per unit wise, 80 rupees per unit is the sales value given. Variable cost is 42 given and it is 38. And if I have to calculate the units, so units, if you will calculate through contribution, through variable cost and sales, units are one and the same. Units are one and the same. So if I'll divide 38,000 by 38, I'll get 1000 units. 1000 is my sales units. Okay. Now you will say, ma'am, will this recheck, if you will tell us by rechecking, is it correct or not? Will this be possible? Yes, it is possible. Right. Let's recheck it, whether it's correct or not. If you want your answer to be correct and you are not sure whether you have done it correct, you can recheck it also. Okay. Now see, my dear students, you have calculated 1000 units through contribution. Okay. Now if I am multiplying, in the question they have given 80 rupees per unit. If I am multiplying it, 80,000 is the answer. Now I have to deduct variable cost, as sales minus variable cost is there. Now 1000 into 42, if I'll deduct, what will I get? 42,000. And if I am deducting sales minus variable cost, what will I get? Contribution. Okay, 38,000. And here also per unit is contribution 38,000. And if I am deducting 38,000 from 38,000, if I'll deduct the fixed cost, that is 20,000, then also I'll get a profit of 10,000. So it is verified. So I hope you learned it. Okay. Moving towards the next question. J sells a product at rupees 6.25. The variable cost are rupees 3.75. J's break-even units are 35,000. What is the amount of fixed cost? So you have to calculate the amount of fixed cost. The units given in question are 35,000. That means at 35,000 units, you have no profits and no loss. Okay. So if you see the chart, sales minus variable cost gives contribution minus fixed cost gives profit. So you have to find out the fixed cost. Profits are zero as break-even units are given. 6.25 is your sales value per unit and 3.75 is what your variable cost per unit. So what you will get, the difference is 2.5, you will get the contribution. Okay, now you know 35,000 is your units, contribution units, because you have no profits. Okay, so 35,000 is your contribution units. Here also 35,000 is there. Here also 35,000 is there because they are talking about the break-even point. Okay, in break-even point there is no profit, no loss, and the units at all stages are same except the fixed cost. Fixed cost is given in the question itself. So at break-even point, my dear students, if profits are zero, that means this amount and this amount have to be same, because from this amount is deducted, then also zero will come. If these both figures are same. So this gives rise to a new formula. Break-even point is equal at break-even point. At break-even point, contribution is equals to fixed cost. So if I'll calculate the contribution, will I get the fixed cost? Yes, because both are same. That's why the answer is coming zero in profits now. So if you will multiply 35,000 into 2.5, what you will get? You will get 87,500. So this 87,500 is your contribution also and your fixed cost also. So the answer is 87,500. If the question ask about contribution, take also 87,500. If the question ask about sales value, then do this. If the question ask about variable cost, then do this calculation. If the question ask about profit, then take on zero. So it can ask in so many ways. Okay. Moving towards the next question, Rocky Limited shows break-even sales of 40,500 and budgeted sales is 50,000. Identify margin of safety ratio. My dear students, it is very simple question. Total sales is equals to margin of safety plus break-even sales, right? And in break-even sales, they are given 40,500 and total sales, that is the budgeted sales, they are given 50,000. So what will be margin of safety? If you will deduct these both, you will get 9,500. So you have to identify margin of safety ratio. That means in percentage. In value it is 9,500, but you have to identify in percentage. So what you will do? MOS upon total sales into 100. If you have to calculate the percentage, so what you will do? 9,500 upon 50,000 into 100. You will get 19%. 19% is the answer. Now if they talk about the percentage of break-even sales, what you will do? It's 81%. If this is 19%, this is 100%, so what will this be? This will be 81%, right? Just a simple plus minus, nothing else. Moving towards the next question, a company makes a single product which it sells for rupees 2 per unit. Fixed cost are 13,000 per month. The contribution upon sales ratio is 40%. Sales revenue is 62,500. What is margin of safety in units? So it is also an easy question which you were finding difficult in the live class. Okay. So I didn't told you in the live class because I wanted you to do practice a little, or you to think. As per me, the options were given wrong if we will solve the formula approach, the MOS approach. But there is another way to do it also. Okay. So let's see here the sales value, which is given is sales revenue. They have given, first of all, the first mistake in this question, they shouldn't have used the word sales revenue as it indicates the profit, but this is a sales figure. Instead, they should have written revenue from operations, or they should have written turnover, or any other word. But if they have written sales revenue also, that means it is a value of sales only. Okay, so total sales, I am assuming the thing which have done, I am assuming the topic they have given in the explanation. So total sales here is 62,500. If you will concentrate on the word sales revenue, you will jump up to that it is a profit. No, it is a sale value. Okay, 62,500. Okay, is your sale value. Now, it is your sales value. Now, it sells for rupees 2 per unit. 2 per unit is the selling price. Now, we are given fixed cost. Another detail which we are given is fixed cost is 13,000 per month. The contribution upon sales ratio, that is PVR, is 40%. And you have to calculate the margin of safety. Okay. So you have been given fixed cost, you have been given PVR. So can you calculate the break-even point? Yes, I can, because total sales is equals to margin of safety plus break-even sales, right? total sales is equals to margin of safety plus break-even sales. Now, if you will look at, if I multiply PVR, PVR, PVR in all these three, what will I get? I'll get here fixed cost. So if I'll divide fixed cost by PVR, I'll get break-even sales. So I am dividing fixed cost, that is 13,000 by 40%, that is PVR. So if I am dividing it, divided by 40%. If you will divide it, you will get 32,500. So your total sales is 62,500. Okay, your total sales is this. Your break-even sales is this, which you have just acquired, 32,500. And what will be the MOS? It will be the difference between these two. So the difference between these two is 30,000. 30,000 and sales value per unit is 30,000 divided by 2, which you will get 15,000. So answer is 15,000. Okay, likewise you can do it. If you don't understand, please ask me on my Telegram channel. If any of the question you have faced difficulty in any of the question, please ask me in my Telegram channel. I will be so happy to help you. Thank you for watching this lecture. Stay tuned. If you face any other questions also, if you are having difficulty in them, please don't hesitate to ask me in the comment section also, or you can subscribe to my Telegram channel also, in which I take doubts personally. I teach them. I give the notifications of my videos. So thank you all for watching this lesson. Stay tuned. Stay blessed. Please go up with all the lessons. As we are standing in November. Your exam is in December. Please gear up and struggle a lot for your exam and aim to achieve an All India rank. Thank you all. Thank you so much.